Hello students, welcome back. I'll be explaining the third stanza of the poem The Rain on the Roof. The file got saved on its own, so let's listen to it in a separate file. So when the poet is lying on his bed and he is lost in the world of dreams, he just gets the reflection of his mother on his mind screen. He starts remembering about the days when her mother was alive and how in the past, before putting him and his siblings to bed, his brothers and sister to bed, how she used to express her love towards them and put on bed and let them sleep till the morning, till the day break, and let them enjoy the world of dreams they were going to transport it into. Oh, I feel her fond look on me. The poet is extremely nostalgic, remembering her mother. The poet becomes so, fondly involved into the memories of the past. So I was just explaining you the word nostalgic here. This expression, oh, when he says oh, it indicates that he is extremely nostalgic about the past. When a person gets into nostalgia, when a person becomes nostalgic, he fondly remembers his past and he experiences a mixed feeling of joy and sorrow. He is joyful because he enjoyed those precious moments happily, and he is sad because those precious moments are no more. So it's a mixed feeling of pleasure and sorrow, the feeling of nostalgia. As I list here means listen, it's the old poetic word list. So as I listen to this refrain, the literal meaning of refrain is a repeated part of a song or a poem. If a poet repeats a particular line of his poem or a song again and again, that is the refrain of the poem. In Hindi songs, you must be seeing that a line repeats again and again. That line is the refrain of the poem. Here, it refers to the sound of the rain, that pitter-patter of the rain falling on the roof of the poet. So as he listens to this music of rain, which is played upon the shingles. Shingles means those blocks, those tiles with which the roof is made of. Here as you can see in the pic, these are the shingles by the patter of the rain. So the pit-pat of the rain is playing upon a music, upon the shingles, playing upon the shingles, a kind of music, a kind of sound, a poem. And when the poet listens to this, this happens to him, that he gets nostalgic. He misses his mother with fondness. He remembers his mother with a feeling of nostalgia, and he gets lost into her mother's memories. Her mother's memories floods in his mind, travels in his mind, and he gets transported to the days, to the ecstatic days, to the exotic days when he spent his time happily with his mother. So this is the explanation of the third stanza. Let's look for the literary devices. A rhyme scheme you can look for on your own, as was explained to you in the first stanza. And literary devices, alliteration. First look for the alliteration. Darling dreamers, there is alliteration here. Again, the word patter is there, that is onomatopoeia. Fine. You can look for this feel, fond. Again, the example of alliteration. Fine. So besides alliteration and onomatopoeia, I don't find any other figure of speech here. Yeah, one more figure of speech I would like to discuss here, which is played upon the shingles by the patter of the rain. As I list to this refrain, which is played upon the shingles by the patter of the rain, this is a single line, students. As I list to this refrain, which is played upon the shingles by the patter of the rain, but this single line has been divided into three fragments, or rather, if we take this line, oh, I feel her fond look on me, as I list to this refrain, which is played upon the shingles by the patter of the urine. This is a one line that has been divided into four lines, four fragments. So when the poet continues a line without using any punctuation to the next line, there is a figure of speech that is enjambment. So I would like you to just know this as well. So enjambment is there. You can look for other examples of enjambment if they are in the stanza 2 and 1 as well. So here the poem has been explained to you in the best possible way, and I hope you'll be revising it, you'll be imbibing it in your heart, and exploring it further at your pace and as per your interest, since poetry has a hidden treasure of beauty that individuals have to explore on their own as per the sensitivity of their hearts. So that opportunity is there with you. You can explore it more further. Thank you so much. You'll be getting two videos of this poem. Thanks a lot.